analyzed a policy by Chile, which since 1974 has been promoting tree plantation on its territory by offering a subsidy to private landowners that would plant trees.
And the hope there was to be able to look at what happens when you design a policy that isn't carefully considering the ecosystems that it might affect. If you design a policy that's just blindly paying people to reforest anywhere, what might happen is that people are reforesting with non-native species, kind of planting these monocultures of timber plantations, and in doing so, replacing really important biodiverse grasslands or native forests even. And so we looked at what happened in Chile over 25 years with the subsidies, and then we look at this counterfactual world where the subsidies never existed. So our main findings were really that the subsidy was effective at increasing the amount of plantations in the landscape. Even though the government was paying hundreds of millions of dollars to plant forests, we didn't really see any significant uptick in net carbon sequestration in the landscape, and we saw a pretty significant drop in biodiversity.
Most of the deforestation we've observed would likely have taken place anyway in the absence of the subsidy, because there was a poor enforcement on the restriction to not expand tree plantation into natural forest. Quite a lot of this plantation actually did lead to the destruction of native forest.
And I think a lot of our research is kind of highlighting this broader relevance of thinking carefully through the environmental consequences of those actions.
Of course, tree plantation is a major pillar of a toolkit to control climate change. If it's not done properly, as was the case in Chile, it can be very costly, with very little benefit for carbon sequestration and actually a loss in terms of biodiversity.